What is up, you guys? It's your boy, Yami Yugi from Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm just kidding. I'm joking. I sound absolutely nothing like him. So, man, I've been wanting to draw the Dark Magician Girl for a while. I've been wanting to draw the Dark Magician Girl because, you know, ever since I was a kid watching Yu-Gi-Oh! In, Kids WB? It was a really cool card. Like, whenever the Dark Magician Girl showed up in like, the duels, it was just like, it's, you know, it was like freaking watching Sailor Moon all over again for some reason, right? And it's just, I don't know, Yugi has one of the coolest decks, right? Dark Magician deck. And then, of course, that would then lead me to build my own Yu-Gi-Oh card deck. And as a kid, I didn't have the money to buy the cards that I want. So, yeah, that didn't go very well. Great thing about being an adult nerd is that you can afford all the shit that you couldn't afford when you were a kid. So, there's victory in that. But anyways, yeah, so the Dark Magician Girl, I had a lot of fun drawing her. I made the pose. So what I did here is I got the pose from another artwork. If you saw the video earlier. And then I went and used a reference of the Dark Magician Girl image to color it. Right, so this pose, she's supposed to look like she's jumping, but I think some people say that she looks like she's like kneeling. But she's supposed to look like she's jumping. Either ways, I have fun. It was a really fun project, and I hope you guys really like it. Right, it's gonna be in my portfolio for whatever purpose I want to be. I haven't figured that out yet. But anyways. I also want to talk about, you know, anime art, right? Because not only has anime dominated American television, or I guess American video streaming, whatever you want to call it, but also anime has become so influential, and a lot of artists are starting to implement it into their own artwork, into their own comic books. And if you've seen the most recent Superman cartoon, what is it called? Superman and His Friends? Superman and Friends, something like that, right? The most recent Superman cartoon, American cartoon, he does a little Sailor Moon transformation. And which I thought was kind of cheesy. I don't know. It didn't look right. Superman doing the transforming into Superman doesn't look so cool. It's not like Wonder Woman. You know, when Wonder Woman transforms into Wonder Woman, like the old school one. That looks cool. I don't know. But Superman, I don't know. It didn't look masculine enough for him. Again, that's just my opinion. You do you, right? So the anime art style is conquering. Anime art style, it's, I've seen so many people just apply it to their art. Especially in the independent comic book, field. I should say, I guess. Is that the right word? In the independent comic book publisher community. That doesn't sound right either, but whatever, man. You guys know what I'm talking about. So anime has been applied, and I see it a lot in, you know, character designers. Right? Character designers, whether if it's American or Eastern, East Asian, they always apply this. It always has this flair, this anime flair, you know, with the big eyes. You can tell if it's influenced by anime. Even the most influential, well, one of the biggest, most popular cartoon in America, Avatar The Last Airbender, looks too much like anime to not be called an anime. But hey, that's for an entire different video, I guess. We can argue about that for ages and never get over it. So it's becoming so popular, and it's funny that back then, you know, people will laugh at you. Some people will laugh at you for like anime, but now it's the norm. Other artists are starting to adapt this, and you know, even if they don't use the anime art style, they'll use that as inspiration. And the great thing about the anime art style is that you don't have to exactly like. You can create your own type of anime art style just by looking at how the Japanese do it, right? If you look at Naruto, it's his own anime art style. If you look at One Piece, his own style. If you look at I guess Bleach or Sailor Moon. I mean, if you go back to the 80s and 90s had a you know, a very unique sort of art style inspired by the old Disney cartoons. And if we fast forward over to the 2000s, we got the more of the Naruto art style, and then we have like the, you know, the Demon Slayers, the and then of course Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball is his own unique art style. I haven't seen too many people copy the Dragon Ball art style. Like, not even other manga artists, they don't really copy the anime, the Dragon Ball art style very much, you know. But yeah, that's the great thing about it. Some people say that, oh, well, all anime looks the same. Well, no, not really. Well, I dare I say it depends. If you're watching like romance anime, like romance comedy anime, those tend to look the same very much, because those are produced rather quickly. So they don't really try to make them very unique. However, when you go to more into the shonen, the seinen type of manga and anime, those tend to look very, you know, very different. Like Berserk, I haven't seen too many people like copy Berserk's art style, if you guys know what I'm talking about. But yeah. And since we're, you know, we're doing the Dark Magician Girl, and it's part of it's from the Yu-Gi-Oh anime. I mean, take a look at the Yu-Gi-Oh anime, the way they designed the eyes. The eyes, I have a love and hate relationship with Yu-Gi-Oh, because the art style is, how should I say, everything is pointy. Everything is like pointy. Everything is just pointy, pointy as hell in Yu-Gi-Oh. Right? The eyes are pointy. They have like this square box-like art, you know, square box-like type of eyes. You know, that's the primary art style of Yu-Gi-Oh. And then the hair is pointy. Everything is pointy in Yu-Gi-Oh. Even the monsters are pointy. Oh, man. I have friends who used to, like, make fun of it, you know, for the whole style just being just so pointy. But that being said, Yu-Gi-Oh! It was such a cool game. It's very unforgettable, too. Like, you can't forget about... Now, there aren't too many card games out there that become popular. Like, let's say, for example... there's Magic. Magic the Gathering. It's a really popular card game. And then in Yu-Gi-Oh! Another popular card game. It became... I don't know if it became as popular as Magic the Gathering, but... Yeah, I would say it's pretty up there. You know? It has a lot of tournaments. I don't see a lot of Magic the Gathering type of tournaments. But Yu-Gi-Oh! Was a big deal, and it's all thanks to the anime. So, yeah, that's pretty much all I had to say about, you know, all this. I don't have much to say about the art styles. I'm just going to let you guys enjoy the rest of the Dark Magician Girls, you know, speed paint here. So go ahead and enjoy it. I'll see you guys at the end of the video.